Some of you are outside, so you might be able to feel the warmth of the sun or hear the sounds of nature and really get that connection with the earth, that sense of being part of nature, held by the nature, rather an insignificant little blip in the world, and yet in harmony with all of life. And as soon as you have your eyes closed, it's like entering your own cave or meditation cell. Even though we're meeting through technology, which is connecting many people around the world, your real home is inside. And through connecting inwardly, you can actually feel more connected with others energetically. And knowing that in the same way, when we're affected maybe by the news or acts of violence, and there's a ripple effect, it affects all of us. In a similar way, we're also affected by the metta, by loving kindness. So when one person practices on the path, that resonates and draws other people in and can strengthen their practice, even if they're on the opposite side of the world. So what we put out is so, so important. So just coming in contact with your body. And seeing if there's anything you can do to make your body feel more at ease, more comfortable, more relaxed. In terms of posture, first of all. Making sure your posture is fairly upright, conducive to being alert, but not stiff, rigid or unnatural. You don't have to have a dead straight back. And at the beginning, just developing that sense of loving kindness and metta, friendship, non-judgment, acceptance, and infusing your awareness with that friendliness. So that as you move your awareness through the body, from the feet up, you're soothing each part of the body, caring for it. With a sense of gratitude and respect. As though your body were a tender young baby. And your awareness is like a warm, soft blanket, covering, soothing, relaxing that baby to sleep. All the tensions draining out into the earth, into the ground. and enjoying that feeling of relaxation. Noticing how good it feels to care. And staying connected to your body, perhaps particularly the area in the chest or any place where it feels fairly pleasant and relaxed, which conduces to an opening of heart. We're going to gently seek forgiveness and offer forgiveness to heal any conflicts or resentments that we may still be carrying, that may be weighing us down. If I've hurt or harmed any being, intentionally or unintentionally, knowingly or unknowingly, by my deeds of body, speech, or mind, I seek forgiveness. And if there's anyone who's hurt or harmed me, intentionally or unintentionally, knowingly or unknowingly, by their deeds of body, speech or mind, if I'm able, I offer them forgiveness. Or I offer them the intention to forgive. Just putting that out there and letting it lie. Letting it do its work. Just opening to the possibility of that forgiveness and how that might feel. Not to condone any behaviour, but just to free the heart. And staying connected to your own body, your own heart. We're going to offer ourselves self-compassion. Forgiveness. If there's anybody who's hurt or harmed me and done something which I'm not yet ready to forgive, I forgive myself for that. Respecting my own process. trusting in one's own intention to forgive. And allowing that process to work itself out. So now, if you're ready, if you wish to follow with the metta, we're going to bring to mind a loved person, someone who's dear to you, with whom you have a very loving, empowering, perhaps, accepting relationship with. Someone who you know wants the best for you, and who you care for deeply. Someone who brings a smile to your mind, a smile to your heart when you think of them. And imagining this person, perhaps in front of you, looking into your eyes, or maybe sitting beside you. Getting a sense of their presence, how it feels to be with them. And imagining the metta in your heart flowing out to this person and suffusing them with loving kindness. May you be happy. May you be free from suffering. May you be healthy. May you be at peace. Choosing some very simple wishes that really capture what you most wish for this person in your life. And just offering these intentions. Listening in the spaces between each phrase to where those words are pointing. The experience of loving kindness in the heart. Keeping the loved person in mind and imagining them receiving this loving kindness, their face brightening, their body relaxing, their heart smiling back at you. just offering loving kindness without any expectation. Giving for the sake of giving. We're going to gently bid farewell to this friend, parent, partner, child, with a smile, thanking them for being in our presence, for sharing our loving kindness, and staying connected to that warm fire in the heart. We're going to invite in a person who is quite neutral to you, who doesn't evoke strong feelings of friendliness or dislike. Sometimes the neutral person is described as the stranger. Someone you don't really know or have any vested interest, or any shared history with. Maybe met them a few times, but don't even know their name. Or they can be slightly better known to you, but you don't really think of them that much. You don't know much about their life, their history. So bringing this person to mind, just getting a sense of that person. It might not be as easy to visualize them. You can have a sense of their humanity, their existence in this world. And start offering them the phrases of loving kindness, staying connected with your heart, with your body. And finding out for yourself how much space you want to leave between each phrase. So if the mind seems to wander, slip away from the object of loving kindness, this neutral person, you might want to close the phrases together, repeat them more regularly. But if you find you can maintain your awareness, the flow of loving kindness, and you can just pop in the phrases whenever you feel that fire needs stoking. Just as you'd feed the fire with another twig or log, whenever it starts to subside. Really letting this person know that you're caring, you're wishing them well. And if you find that the loving kindness starts to fade at all, you can go back to the loved person. Just build it up again, to even it out. Or even bring that loved person in, so that there are three of you sharing this loving kindness. If you feel ready and you wish, you can also bring in a person with whom you have difficulties. You might not like this person very much. There may be some conflict, resentment, or tension there. And see if you can offer them too, these intentions, thoughts, wishes of loving kindness, recognizing that they too want to be happy. They don't wish to suffer, but they may cause suffering for others without knowing, just as we ourselves inevitably do. So bringing in this person, if it feels reasonably comfortable, knowing that you can always bid farewell whenever you're ready and go back to the neutral person or the loved person. You can experiment with how close you bring this person in. You maybe want a little bit more distance than you had with the loved person. Staying mindful of your body, of any physical or emotional responses, and just allowing them to be there. Opening your heart respectfully, gently, kindly to whatever arises. If you find that the metta is still flowing fairly strongly, please stay with this difficult person or the neutral person, whoever you're practicing with. If you find that the metta started to subside at this point, then gently bid farewell to the difficult person and go back to the loved person just for a few minutes. Recognizing that feeling of safety, of well-being in the presence of a friend. to gently bring to mind all the people sharing this space, the people in this virtual room. And spread metta among us. Imagining that metta connecting us all wherever we're sitting, whichever country we're in. As our metta is shared, it becomes supercharged. Metta may start spilling over, wanting to spread, to reach out beyond any physical boundaries, beyond individuals, into the different directions. We're going to just allow that metta to spread in front of us. Imagining that energy reaching far and wide, contacting whichever beings are in that direction, whichever beings come to mind. Spreading out further and further. In the forward direction. Do this purely in an energetic way, without words, if you are able. If you prefer, you can add thoughts of loving kindness. May all beings in front of me be happy. Be peaceful, be liberated, all beings, human, non-human, visible or invisible, to the furthest reaches. In this world or beyond, may all beings be free from suffering and free from the causes of suffering. May their hearts be truly free. You find this metta wants to keep spreading. To your right, to all beings on the right of you. This metta's flowing in that direction, like a blanket or a wave. Alleviating the suffering of all beings it contacts. Spreading outwards and unbounded. Spreading to the direction behind you, covering more and more of this universe, all the beings, human or non-human, visible or invisible, far or near. Whether beings come to mind or not, everything's fine. Allow them in. And keep spreading this loving kindness to your left, to all beings on the left of where you're seated. Allowing this metta to ooze out of every pore. Boundless and immeasurable loving kindness. Might notice that the metta naturally starts flowing out below to all beings below where you're seated, in the earth, in the oceans, deep underground. And all beings in the upward direction. Spiders on the ceiling, birds in the sky. As far as that metta wants to spread, in every direction. Until there are truly no boundaries or borders. And just resting in that sense of expansion. gently come back into the body, imagining all that metta coming straight in through your pores. You again start to notice the boundary of the body, the skin, the shape of the limbs. Where you're seated, or maybe lying down. And just offering yourself loving kindness. Using whatever words or images you wish. Maybe a hand on the heart. So that you're really contacting yourself. As a sentient being also, desiring your own happiness. Facing your own struggles and difficulties. With a really deep sense of respect, offering yourself loving kindness, forgiving, powerful, unconditional love. Sabbe sata, sabbe pana, sabbe bhuta, sabbe pugala, sabbe atabawa pariya. Sabba itiyo, sabbe purisa, sabbe ariya, sabbe anariya, sabbe deva. Sabbe manusa, sabbe vinipadika, aveva hontu, abhyapaja hontu, aniga hontu. Sukhiyatanam pariharantu, dukkham unjantu, yadaladasampatito, maa.